Hello and welcome back to Proactive Investors. Joining me today from Discovery Alaska is Managing Director Jerko Zuvela. Jerko, welcome to the program. Delighted to have you here with us today.
Thank you very much. It's lovely to be with you today.
So Jerko, let's kick off discussions around the three new lithium assets that you've just picked up. You've signed heads of agreement to pick up three new lithium assets over in Canada's James Bay location. Bring us up to speed on the story so far.
Yeah, as you said, we were able to put our announcement out on Monday regarding the potential acquisition of these three new lithium projects in the James Bay region in Quebec, Canada. It's obviously very exciting for us. It's been an area that has been in recent times, I guess, by a couple of other companies, ASX listed companies that have done very well. So we're very excited about the three projects, very prospective for lithium and spodumene potential. We're sort of in the areas where some of those other groups, Patriot Battery Metals, Winsome Resources, and obviously the James Bay area in general is well known and well regarded for lithium projects, where there's Allkem up there and Sayona and a few others there. So we've done a little bit of work to identify the projects. We've been able to strike what we think is a very good terms to allow us to have this option period or DD period initially to do a little bit of due diligence works to assess the projects, and then some stage payments as we progress the projects to allow us to continue those exploration works. And you know, the more we find, the more we continue and the more we progress. It's very exciting for us to be up in that part of the world, a little bit of a move from Alaska, but all still, you know, that part of the world. And we're very excited to see what we can find and hopefully join the lithium rush up in Quebec.
Certainly keeping the focus on North American lithium here. And in fact, it makes sense because Quebec has really made a name for itself in recent years as an iconic lithium district. Plenty of famous neighbours in the region and looking at James Bay, as you said. So as you complete this due diligence program, Jerko, what are your exploration plans for these projects?
Yeah, so we've engaged a consulting group out of Canada to conduct those due diligence works. And in addition to that, obviously start, assuming it all goes well, start planning an exploration program for the summer period coming up in North America in Canada. So we'd love to be able to get out on the ground. It is early stage projects. So we'll go and do some surveying, initial exploration works. But obviously the intention is to identify those pegmatite areas and get a drill rig in as quickly as possible and see what we can find in our three projects as well. Obviously, it covers a lot of ground. I think about 180 square kilometres in total. So we think we've got a very good chance to hopefully finding something. The vendors are locals, some geologists in their group as well. So they think they've done a very good job in identifying these prospective areas. And we'll be working together with them as well to assist us in doing those exploration works. But yeah, the plan would be to do those initial surveying and reconnaissance works and try to line up based on hopefully some surface expressions, try to line up that drilling program, whether it's this year or as quickly as possible. We can drill during the winter months up there as well. So, we can continue those exploration works and see what we can find. And obviously the aim will be to try to do as much as we can within our means prior to that milestone at the end of the year where we need to make some payments for those projects.
Certainly lots of ground to keep you busy here. Jerko, I'm sure investors will want to know as well, how do these three new lithium assets fit into your current portfolio?
Yeah, so as I said earlier, obviously with the name, we've got a project, the Chilitna project up in Alaska. That's prospective for gold and some base metals, but also for lithium. We did do some works up there over the last couple of years looking for lithium. So, it fits in nicely. We haven't given up on Alaska. We're still looking. We do like the gold and lithium potential in that part of the world. So we'll continue, whether it's with that project or maybe even looking at some additional opportunities down the track. We think we've got a good foothold in Alaska. And given sort of the nature of that part of the world, we think it's a good fit with moving into Quebec, albeit, a different country and the other side of the the continent there, but we've got some very good connections through these consulting groups, through the people we had working for us in Alaska, that you know will be quite advantageous for conducting works on the ground. So we think it's a good natural fit. It does keep focusing our attention on the battery metal sector, plus you know precious metals, and you know we think there's some good opportunities to keep going and pushing hard with the projects that we've got in the portfolio at the moment.
Interesting to hear how these acquisitions will complement your existing precious and battery metal interests. Jerko Zuvela, thank you so much for your time and bringing us up to speed on this important acquisition.
Thank you very much, Alicia.